David, the subject that Maria Sison was teaching us was political thought. And that's why he contaminated us early on, and we became the first kabataang makabayan. You know, until now, if I make it, God willing, to the presidency, I will be the first left president in this country. And that's the reason why I raise my fist, because I am a member of Bayan. Bayan has always been my political party, but I am not a member of the Communist Party of the Philippines.
Duterte, maluwag yung bunga nga. Sabi niya, yung kapag akong presidente, isang paa ng NPA nasa mga hanggang na. No? Ready for coalition. Kapag akong presidente, isang paa ng NPA nasa Malacanang na. No? Ready for coalition.
Sa state banquet, pinuri pa ni Si sa Duterte at ikinumpara siya kay Rizal.
Well, nakikinig naman yung mga NPA, nasa pwesto pa naman kayo. Ano kaya yung korte nito? Ang korte ninyo? Korte ninyo na, I don't know if it's a kangaroo or otherwise, pagpatay na lang niyo para mas madali ang ma-solusyon ng problema natin. Kuya Diyas, sa bukid, tatapusin na ninyo yan. Mas mabuti, wala na rin kayong ginagawa. There's a slowdown in the fighting. Why should we be fighting? When it's a matter of fact, I'm just waiting for the arrival of Sison to talk to him.
There are three processes by which the Philippine Revolution is to be advanced. These include the building of the Communist Party of the Philippines, the building of the New People's Army, and the building of the National Democratic Front. The Communist Party of the Philippines was established on December 26, 1968 as the Marxist-Leninist vanguard party of the working class. This party is supposed to be the standard bearer of the working class, which is that class that is the most progressive, productive, and political force in the Philippines. It is true that a minority class, especially only the party which represents it, cannot win the Philippine Revolution all by itself. At any rate, even while there are the forces of armed revolution, there are the legal democratic forces in the Philippines. The biggest of these is Bagong Alyansang Makabayan, or Bayan in short.
I started with Bayan.
It has a membership of more than 2 million members in more than 1,000 member organizations.
And this is very rare to see a sitting president now literally having a good discussion with these people, and they're also hoping that President Duterte is the man for change this time.
And we hope to see and find out later on what are the contents of that people's agenda that they submitted to the president.
Yes.
Now we see the painting.
Paintings. Yes, this was I saw this on Facebook after they held their multi-sectoral meet, and what we can see now, the explanation of what the painting is about. I wonder where the president will be placing that painting, because he's also he's a leader that says he is a leader of left leaning. He believes in socialism. He believes that everything should be fair and equal. So there you see, unprecedented again, another post. This time,
there.
This is one sight we rarely see. We would normally see them on the streets protesting against the president.
And now we see them directly
inside the palace with the president, presenting their agenda also. And I'm pretty sure President Duterte will go over this. That is a rare video of the multi-sectoral, and these are the leftist groups inside the palace. And now
its biggest component organizations are Kilusang Mayo Uno, which is the labor center, the Pambansang Kilusang Magbubukid, which is the, or the Kilusang Magbubukid ng Pilipinas, or KMP, Gabriela, the Women Alliance, League of Filipino Students.
And we became the first kabataang makabayan. And that's the reason why I raised my fist, because I am a member of Bayan.
Alliance of Concerned Teachers, Cadena, and so on. As I have earlier pointed out, Partido ng Bayan, founded last August 30 and 31, was an outgrowth of Bayan, the big coalition.
Since the Cory administration, lumakas ang NPA. Mas marami ang pinatay ng NPA na mahirap na mamayan kaysa yung napatay ng mga AFP noon. Ang napapalabas, parang ang AFP ang nagkakamali. Pero if you look at the data, mas maraming pinatay ng NPA. Even missionaries, priests, in the Cordilleras, si Father Leo, an old missionary, they just liquidated him and inilibing nila na hindi na namin alam kung nasaan si Father Leo. Yung mga Protestant pastors, yung mga tribal leaders na ang dami nilang pinatay, maski yung mga liquidation sa mga bata.
Duterte, maluwag yung bunganga. Sabi niya, yung kapag akong presidente, isang paa ng NPA nasa mga handa na. No? Ready for coalition.
If you would notice, historically, why is it that there's so much killing during political exercises? Why do you think people kill the guys on the other side? Because in this country, there are about only few guys, the billionaires here in Manila, the Imperial Manila, to choose the president for us. Ayaw ko maging presidente. Why are you insisting on me? Eh kasi namimili, and those elected really take care of the elite, the billionaires here. Yung basta yung gusto kanila, gusto ka pag ayaw ka, and if you are not a member of the ruling elite, stay out. Well, that is why sabi ko, gusto ninyo. Oh, they will hear. But if I become president, I'd be prim and proper. Ito namang, nasa gobyerno, they have to steal. They have to make money to sustain their partisan group in a society. That is the reason why. Because we have kept our country in eternal poverty.
And Chinese.
And those elected really take care of the elite, the billionaires here
of the Philippines. Executive Secretary Salvador Mijaldi and other members of the Cabinet, honorable members of the Senate and House of Representatives, officials and members of the Chinese-Filipino Business Club, Incorporated, other guests, mga kababayan. I'd like to thank the Filipino-Chinese, especially community, for their untiring toil to help the entire nation in the so many catastrophes and crises that we had faced in the past.
Salamat po. Kindly sit down. Thank you for your courtesy. Former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, Excellencies Basojao of China, a great neighbor of the Republic of the Philippines, Executive Secretary Salvador Mijaldi and other members of the Cabinet, honorable members of the Senate and the House of Representatives, officials and members of the Chinese-Filipino Business Club, Incorporated, other guests, mga kababayan. I'd like to thank
the Filipino Chinese especially community for their untiring toil to help the entire nation in so many catastrophes and crises that we had faced in the past. I know that your feeling towards the Filipino, well, most of us are really almost of Chinese ancestry. We love our country and we love the people. I would like to dispense at this time reading a two-page speech because I have to talk about the pressing demands and issues of the country. Ang una po, ganito, let me address yung sa China. You know, maraming mga experts dyan, lahat na, lalo na yung kabila, that I exert more serious effort in pressing for the demands of the West Philippine Sea or the China Sea for that matter. Alam mo, sa totoo lang, whatever it is, what are the theories of relationships in the field of geopolitics, wherever you are, it's always changing. Geography is changing, not the physical movement, but geography and politics, international politics, changes all the time. Now we are allies with each other, maybe enemies before, or ideological differences which were fundamental now, just theories now. China has put a stake there that it is also a property of China. So may difference na ngayon. So that how do we resolve it? The critics say that I am not doing enough. Lalo na yung itong, what were they doing during their time? Why did they not start to build things, their structures that China is doing now? So even in the claim itself and in the development of that claim, wala tayong ginawa. Now, nandyan ang China building structures and military bases, I must admit it. But is it intended for us? You must be joking. It's not intended for us. The contending ideological powers of the world or the geopolitics has greatly changed. It's really intended against those who the Chinese think would destroy them, and that is America. I will not go into a battle which I can never win. Now, how will I win it? Well, China. We have this RPUS pact, defense deal. We will honor it. I don't know when. But if we go to war, everything wilts. Lalaya ito lahat. Because, you know, North Korea is the wild card. But the tip appears to be tempering its policies. And I have to pray. I do not pray usually, but I pray to once, twice. When it enters my mind about what's happening with the world, one mistake, and if all those nuclear weapons are launched, China will join the fray, Russia, Britain, France, and Iran. So if those atomic weapons are blown up, there is no more territory to fight for. There is no more ideology to cause friction because we will see each other in heaven. Talagang matutunaw ito. Just imagine one Hiroshima a million times. The bomb in Hiroshima multiplied a million times. That will happen. What will happen to the world? Kaya China, Russia, America ay nakatutok yan. This is stalemate. Do not pull the trigger because mine will also go off. And we are at a very proximate distance to assure mutually dead. O sino ngayon ang... So why would I... So I go to Russia. I said, Mr. President Putin, can I buy... I'll give you. Plus trucks. And I don't know, I'm not in a position really to talk about it. The military.
I'm Chinese.
From Xiamen. Itong claim sa China Sea, talagang atin yan, insofar as the Republic of the Philippines is concerned. So the war now is on trade, not territory. That's why you said geopolitics is always changing. Philippines now is veering towards China, but we maintain good relations. I know that your feeling towards the Filipino, well, most of us are really almost of Chinese ancestry. We love our country and we love the people. Alam ko yan kasi isa ako sa inyo of Chinese ancestry.
I'm Chinese.
From Xiamen. I'd like to thank the Filipino Chinese, especially.
The billionaires here,
the elite. Itong claim sa China Sea, talagang atin yan. I am ready, almost ready, to put my presidency, my career as president, my life and honor. Akin yan, I've stated it in black and blue. Now it has been the claim of the Republic of the Philippines na atin yan, which we now call the China, which we called before China, the China Sea, now the West Philippine Sea. Walang kadududa. In front of the ambassador, I tell you, we will insist. But what would be the components of our demands and our insistence? Well, we can only be diplomatic. We can only be talking on friendly and civilized terms.
Kaya ganon, kung bakit magtanong, bakit ba dito? Sa Pilipinas, patayan.
Data, mas maraming pinatay ng other NPA.
Some don't.
No big deal. NPA.
Now, tinatanong niya ako, anong tribo ni Duterte? Bakit masama ang bunga niyan?
Well, we trace our pedigree sa papa. On Saturday, ang lolo ko, Chinese. From Xiamen. So I have a line in my family na puro moro.
Ang Chinese.
From Xiamen.
Sa state banquet, pinuri pa ni Xi si Duterte at ikinumpara siya kay Rizal.
Ang Chinese.
So my father came from Cebu. So kung magtanong kayo, anong tribo mo, Duterte? Cebuano? Nakatira ka ba doon? Hindi. Bakasyon lang. May kilala ka sa doon? Wala rin. Kasi nakatira ako sa Davao. Doon ako lumaki. Pero ba, kami doon sa Visayas nga, we grew up in a neighborhood. Mix kami lahat. No tribe can claim dominance there.
I'm Chinese.
Frank Yamin. I'm not trying to equate myself with you or identify myself with you, but they want it prim and proper. They control the media, they control television and all. And they want to do
to transport food and water
governance
in the disputed waters
in accordance
away from the outpost Chinese Coast Guard vessels
to with their interest
food and water to an outpost.
That's how it is. Noon pa ganun talaga ang maliliwan lang yan. And this elite, you know, they want to chart the history of our country in their eyes, in their mind. Ay, yung iba naman pumapalag.
Maniwala kayo kasi yan ang commitment sa akin ng China. And galing kay si Xi Jinping mismo nagsabi, and he's a man of honor. Kaya nga sabi ko, why are you so sparing? Gusto ninyo, gawain na lang ninyo kaming province, Fujian, pati Philippine province of China. Di wala tayong problema. We share. Libre na lahat. Kasi yung oil, joint naman. Yung oil mo, dito mo yung pinakamarami. Tsaka probinsya na kami. Oh, province of Philippines, Republic of China. The nearest is Fujian.
That is the reason why. Because we have kept our country in eternal poverty.
Makuha mo ang Philippines, wala nang problema. Kasi maraming pera eh.
Paano kung pagising mo eh, probinsya na pala ng China ang Pilipinas? Sa harap ng Chinese-Filipino businessman at ni Chinese Ambassador Xiao Xuanhua, na gawing probinsya na lang ng China ang Pilipinas.
I'm Chinese,
Frank Yamin.
Sa gitna naman ng agawan sa teritoryo, kinikilala sa isang lungsod sa China
ang ating kinabukasan sa kamay ng may kapangyarihan. Yun lang naman eh. Will we allow power to dictate where this country will go? Meron pa ba akong iiwan sa mga millennials, sa mga kabataan ngayon na pwede nilang sabihin proud ako dito dahil Pilipino ako? Meron pa bang karagatan sa West Philippine Sea na pwede kong sabihin Pilipino ako sa amin pinamana ang Spratlys, ang Kalayaan Island. Sa amin pinamana ang Spratlys, ang Kalayaan Island. Sa amin pinamana ang Spratlys, ang Kalayaan Island. Pilipino ako, hindi namin pinapayagan na sirain ang bayang Pilipinas. Mahalagang mahalaga ang eleksyon na ito. Kapag ipamigay natin ang ating boto sa mga nasa top ng survey na nakita ko, parang ibinenta na rin natin ang ating kaluluwa. Wala tayong
Jinjiang sa kontribusyon ng mga Chinese-Filipino, hindi lang sa ekonomiya ng Pilipinas.
Hindi tayo magigising sa isang bayan na masasabi natin na Pilipinas. Pinaligyan na natin ito dun sa kung sino ang may hawak ng baril, sino ang may hawak ng kapangyarihan.
May patayan para magkita-kita at pagkaisa ang paralabanan ng mga magdaraya. Ay, hindi sila magtatagal sa
pangyarihan. What the impetus was for you to speak out? What did you see? I was a lawyer and I saw securities fraud. I saw financial information that was not being disclosed to $180 billion worth of bondholders. It was my job to make sure that the financial statements were correct.
So first,
I reported it up the corporate ladder to the audit committee. When that didn't work, I went to the U.S. Treasury Department,
nasa ang gabinete.
And when that didn't work, I went to the U.S. Congress.
Ay, ito.
Senator Lugar wrote three letters to the World Bank saying, don't fire this lady. And they promptly fired
me. Boss,
this means medyo that the U.S. Congress does not have the information that it needs.
Hindi po yata so maganda na bilang isang presidente.
After I was fired, three senators asked for a GAO inquiry into the corruption that I was reporting at the World Bank. Senators Lugar, Leahy, and Bayh. Walk us through what exactly, you know, where was the money being laundered to whom?
Para lamang
the money
sabihin
was going
sa kanyang leader
because anybody that reported misconduct was fired. So in one case, the borrowers were being overcharged.
Lucio Tan at Henry C. Proud ang mga tagkasama na rito ang ilang business tycoon kagaya ni Lucio Tan at Henry C. Kasama
in another case, I was reporting corruption in the Philippines. $900 million worth of money that should have gone to fight poverty in the Philippines instead went to a corrupt man, Lucio Tan, who was in default on his loan. Philippine National Bank went into default. There was a run on the bank. Philippine National, the investment company tried to bail out the bank for $500 million. And then the board was lied to. And my story is about trying to uncover the cover-up. The cover-up went all the way to Congress, and then it went to 188 ministers of finance. So this is corruption in the entire world. And until it's set straight, what we're going to have is we're going to have a currency
war. Ano gusto niyang marinig? Pagka ganyan, magpapatuloy yung kanyang mga nasa sa isip at nasa sa bibig. I don't think any leader deserves to be allowed to say what he wants, to do what he wants, without his closest friends and supporters correcting him. Ganun din tayo sa bayan. Kapag tumahimik tayo at sinabi natin, kagaya ng spokesman, na paniwalaan nyo to dahil ang may sabi nito ay presidente, wala ng Pilipinas. Sinasabi lang natin, kung ano sinabi nitong nasa taas, paniwala, di utu-utu na.
Why all of a sudden the position of the Philippines have changed? How sincere is this China policy?
Maybe because I'm Chinese. We should not be too constrained to follow the dictates of any other country.
So what's the use? So what's the use of going into this useless exercise when, after all,
and we are the neighbors next door?
Yes.
And they are far away.
Far away.
Across the ocean.
Thousands of miles away.
Across the ocean.
Yes.
Wala, di utu-utu natan tayong lahat. Wala, di utu-utu natan tayong lahat. Wala, bawal palang magtanong, bawal palang pumuna, bawal palang magsabi ng totoo doon sa aking sinusuportahang leader. That's the worst support you can ever give to a leader that of a country. If you really are supportive of your leader, dapat sa isang magandang usapan masasabi mo kung ano yung tama, ano yung mali, mapapaalalahan. Boboto ako sa susunod na eleksyon, Mayo 13. Dahil yung nag-iisang boto ko, ayokong ibenta. Dahil nag-iisang boto ko, meron niyang kahalagahan. Kahit ang 100 milyong Pilipino ay bumoto sa magnanakaw, sa sinungaling, sa mamamatay tao, ayokong masabi ng susunod na henerasyon na lahat ng Pilipino nakalimutan kung sino sila. Yung 1 boto ko, itatayo ko yan para sa katotohanan, para sa Pilipinas. Mayo 13 po, marami tayong pwedeng gawin. Pwede po tayong mag-beach, pwede tayong manalangin na lang, pwede tayong manood na lang ng TV. Pero sa Mayo 13, ang kinabukasan ng Pilipinas nasa kamay nyo. Kailangan po nating gumising ng umaaga, pumunta sa ating presinto, at bumoto ng tama. Boto po yan para sa akin, boto po yan para sa kapwa Pilipino boto po yan para sa bayang Pilipinas. Bumoto po tayo sa Mayo 13. Maraming maraming salamat po si Brother Armin Luistro po ng De La Salle Brothers, Presidente po ng De La Salle Philippines. Now you vote!